Hey everybody, and welcome to League of StarCraft Chicago. I am Menasor, a platinum level Zerg player from Albuquerque, New Mexico, and I'm here to cast some games for some players so they can build some meta and work on knowing what their opponents are doing and stuff, because that's cool. We're going to start with a best of three, Wolf Brother vs. JTech. Is it still SMG JTech? Oh yeah, I love that. So, I know both of these players, SMG JTech not as well as I do Wolf Brother. But in the top left-hand position, we do have that green Protoss player. His name is SMG JTech. He's also from the first season of League of StarCraft Chicago. And same as with Wolf Brother, who represents Team Groupon. I've seen both these players play. I'm really excited to see this TVP. I'm not sure. I think they're both pretty even. I remember SMG JTech being the okay player, being good. So, not being, you know, he understands that. Best of luck, buddy. Oh, he's such a nice dude. So, Wolf Brother is a great macro in Terran. He's been incorporating some different builds. I've seen him do mech lately, which is absolutely fabulous. And he's having fun with the game, you know. You can't hurt a guy. You can't hate a guy for wanting to love the game, you know. Be true to the game, you know. So, we're probably going to see Wolf Brother go for that Reaper expand, because against Protoss, he'll be able to scout, check stuff out, at least until the Mothership Core comes out. He just needs to make sure that it's not, if he's got to see the gas timing. Is it one gas? Is it two gas? If it's two gas, what's that tech going into? Is it going to be DTs? Is it going to be a proxy starport? I mean, a proxy Stargate? I mean, what's it really going to be? And I love his building placement. He does put his... He puts the depot here for vision, but he puts his buildings next to his command center just in case there's a blink all-in. And with the meta these days, Protoss likes to do the blink all-in. Come on, who doesn't like blink all-in, because it works most of the time, especially on this map. There's just a whole array of area to just blink into. We're going to see an SCV scout early to look for this guy. Unfortunately, SMG JTech will not be able to find Wolf Brother in fast fashion, unless, of course, no, both. Wolf Brother is going north. He will find him first. SMG JTech will not be able to find it, but I basically could say that, you know, SMG JTech will know that Wolf Brother is to the south of him. It sucks being Protoss. It's hard to scout. It's hard to know things, so you just have to do things that you know when, because you can't really, you know, do other things. We are seeing that Reaper come out. That Reaper will be able to scout, see all sorts of cool shit. But, I mean, there's really not much to see here. It's a very safe gateway cyber opening. As soon as cyber's done, we're going to see... Oh, does he love the 4-gate? I remember... Who was it? I think he loves the 4-gate, from what I remember. Who doesn't love the 4-gate? Oh, yeah, we are seeing it being researched immediately. Where will the Chrono Boost go is the question. What do you want to chrono? Oh, you're going to chrono that stalker because you know that Reaper's on its way and you want to be able to get it out of there. Expanding on the bottom. Expanding on the low ground like a boss is Wolf Brother. Wolf Brother getting that reactor core, not knowing what's up yet. He probably knows the meta of this guy anyway. We will see his other gas come down in a moment, as well as his third barracks. So he will be able to get out something to stop that. If in fact, that's don't lose that Reaper. Do not lose that Reaper. That would be terrible. All right, great. Well, we're seeing more gateways come down. Are you actually going to put down a Nexus? It looks like you're going to put down a Nexus. Will you put down a Nexus for me? You have to. Yeah, you have to, because you're putting all your Chrono into not Warp Gate. And Wolf Brother doing good, chilling. Is he going to get that gas? Where's that second gas? Can you get it? No? No, that's okay. So we have the few more barracks coming down. Natural will be up in a minute. This probe lost its opportunity to try to electrify this SCV and stop building this. We are seeing the orbital come down. Two marines will shoo away this or kill it. Probably kill it. Will it be first blood? And it will be first blood. Keeping him out. What else? We're just seeing gateways in a robo, so it's very safe. This is a very safe build. Protoss wants to just probe up, get his two base and figure out what he's doing. He's going to get an observer or two out to watch what Wolf Brother's doing. And this is actually great for Wolf Brother because he's a macroing Terran. He loves macroing Marines and killing people with lots of them. So this will be very interesting to see in general. Love these macro games. So they both know where each other are, yeah. What I would like to see is Wolf Brother take a quick third. Just for shits. Just take that quick third. Be greedy. What would I like to see the Protoss do? Other than get a soul? I don't know. Yeah, just probe. Just do good. We will see him transition to Colossus tech, and this was a problem, you know, in the previous season of League of StarCraft Chicago. Wolf Brother had a real big problem with dealing with or getting his Viking count up or knowing when to get his Viking count going. So we'll have to see how he's going to transition into late game TVP, because there's going to be a lot of area of effect. There's going to be lots of AoE damage, and he needs to be able to deal with that or be able to deal with part of it so then he can snipe or do whatever he needs to do. I've never seen him go Ghost ever. I would love to see a nuke. Lord knows I love nukes. Nothing too out of the ordinary. We are seeing that observer on an intercept course for not nowhere in particular, just down here. Let's see the worker leads. 38 to 36, very even game right now. Super even. First observer is there, checking out the army, checking out what's going on. Wolf Brother should drop a scan and kill the fuck out of it. Widowmines? He could use Widowmines this game, or is he just doing this so he can get switch it and get medevacs and Vikings? So yeah, we're just waiting for stuff to happen right now. So Double Forge coming down right now. Not necessarily late, because the infrastructure of SMGJ Tech is up. We do have both bases very well saturated. We do have really good macro going on. Very good macro going on. Wolf Brother getting his third and fourth gas is that will just pile up a bit, unfortunately. He is getting turrets, defensive turrets. He doesn't want to have to deal with anything super weird coming to his base. He hasn't necessarily scouted that well. Still have that Reaper. No, that Reaper's been dead for a minute, so. Extended Thermal Lance being researched right now. This is pretty exciting. So, I mean, Wolf Brother should know this is going to happen, and he should start making Vikings. Soon. Get another starport. It'd be sweet just to make a crap load of Vikings, kill the Colossus, and then drop them and be like, yeah! Guess what? Mech dick. Combat shield's about to finish. Another tech lab going down. Some more add-ons going down. We do have a third coming down from SMGJ Tech. This is kind of risky. He has a lot of shit that dies so easy to Marines. So if this was pressuring here, or just even staying out here, it'd probably be able to beat the shit out of this. Because if one thing that Stalkers don't have, it's DPS. And we're having Wolf Brother move out like a boss. Move up there. Move out. Destroy that third. This is a very aggressive bio. Pack of bio here. We do have... Where is that? Okay, yeah. We do have plus one weapons started. I mean, it's kind of... It's fine timing, I guess. I mean, with everything that's going on, I mean, he's spending his money good. But he wanted to get an infrastructure down in order to start macroing out some units and get a sizable army out. We're going to see... the first Colossus is out. Extended Thermal Range. Lance is done. We'll have another one come out in just a moment. So... We'll have to see this engagement. He should go on the high ground. Can they see it? No, just attack the third. Just attack the third. Don't go up there. Don't get in this vision either. Okay, he's going to go up there. He's just going to take a look real quick and be like, hey, what up? Hopefully move that army out of position. Uh-oh. And then when he sees those rays of death, he needs to just move out of there. Yeah, yeah. Move out of there. Just snipe this. Who gives a crap? Viking production has started. Good. So, yeah. Will he get caught out here, though? This is a pretty... Oh, my God! Dude, watch out, Wolf Brother. You need to just get out of there. You need to just step and just go. Or maybe you want to take this fight? I don't think so. Just not enough. You gotta just run. Run. Don't lose Medivac either. It's good that he doesn't have Blink. He can blink it and be like, bam, bam, bam. Die, Medivac. And he's boosting. Is there a lot of... Yes, he's going to meet up with some Vikings and a pack of bio. So this may not be a good idea from SMG JTech. They just want to scan, make sure there's no DTs, nothing stupid. He's going to try to bait them back. Oh, is he going to try to snipe the Colossus? He's going to try to snipe the Colossus, but he doesn't get up there. But his Vikings are doing work on him. They're out of the way. He's able to take out the Stalkers and the Sentry. This is absolutely awesome, and there's not enough stuff to stop that other stuff from killing these. But no! Wow! It's barely. It's such a close fight. The Vikings die way too early. And, oh, we have that proxy pylon coming down. This is going to be just a three, this kind of aggression so he can get his third base up. We do have more Vikings out on the field. Let's get more of a bird's eye view. We do have two Widow Mines that will be able to do some work on this little pack of army, but he needs more Vikings. Oh no, he needs to go now. Yes, go now, go now, go now. Yes, 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 kill. Kill, Wolf Brother. Kill those Colossus. Cool. So that was stopped. That was thrown. That if he would have waited any longer, there would have been a lot of crap on his doorstep. And we have Wolf Brother in the supply lead by 30 supply. He does have his third down. He is putting mules on. He's getting his fifth and sixth gases. So this is absolutely great. Where's his? And he can max out. All he has to do is just queue. He needs to get up there. He needs the pressure. Those two Colossus died. He has free reign to destroy this if he wants to. So Wolf Brother's now going to move up. He's going to bring his Widow Mines with him. No, he needs to pause. Okay, ready, go. Yeah, cool. Everything worked out just good. Just good, fine girlfriends. Okay, so Wolf Brother. Awesome position right now. But part of his lead right now is getting diminished. And where are his upgrades? Is he on 2-2 yet? And they're not even... His 2-2's not even going. He's getting his armory now so he can unlock those there. Oh my god, this is a lot of gateways. So, this is a very tense moment. Wolf Brother can take this game for the win if he can get up there quick enough to kind of stop this macro stuff here. Or stop him from having production. Because there's only one Colossus, and that's very easy to snipe. We do have Storm coming in. Oh my god, this is terrible. Go, go, go kill, go kill. There's no reason not to go kill. Yes, yes. Know where his army is. Yeah, you know where his army is. You know what he has. You can destroy this. You can put him behind a bit. Oh my god, you almost have it. Yes. Good. So move back. You don't need to engage. Get him into the Widow Mines. Kill. Oh yeah, I love Widow Mines. And you don't have to attack on the leader, but you're doing good. This is good. Goodbye. Yeah, Wolf Brother, yeah. So SMG JTech really needs to get out some units right now. And, I mean, his Storms. I mean, he does have Zealots. Zealots and Colossus are great. Stalkers are kind of not so good right now. But that's okay. But he needs to get stuff out right now. He needs to get stuff out right now to stop this. And those Vikings are going to tear apart. Yeah, they're going to tear apart that Colossus. And there's just so much stuff here from Wolf Brother. I'm not really... Oh, but here come the Storms! Here come the Storms! Light the sky! No, it's not happening. Or is he going to wait till he's in a bad position? Because right now, he's so bunched up. Yeah, bring that in. Awesome. So Wolf Brother's bringing in quite a bit of stuff. There's a Colossus not fighting with everybody else. There's AoE here that's not destroying this army that's all clumped up. So SMG JTech kind of falling behind in the regards to using his AoE. And there's enough Marauders here that they could just get out of that storm and just overwhelm. And this is but there's a really good storm. And another really good storm needs to get out of it. Needs to heal. Yeah? Cool. Awesome. What else is up there? So we have more High Templar coming out right now. We have a lot of Zealots. We need more reinforcements. And guess what? They have arrived! Where are the other Colossus? We do have another base going up in the top right on this area, but I don't think it's going to be enough. We have basically over a 50 supply lead from Wolf Brother. We don't have... We almost have some Storms here. And they're making Archons. He just needs to make Archons. You can drop the Vikings if he wants to. There aren't any more. We do have a Ghost Academy down. But it looks like this is going to be it. This bio is going to shred through this. There is a Medivac for every Marauder here. And we will see the GG from SMGJ Tech. Yep, we will see it. Wolf Brother took his fourth as well. And there we go. Well played. Has left game. So game one goes to Wolf Brother. Let's check out this here game two. Here we go. Habitation Station. TVP. PVT. So the... on this map... it's sort of Terran favored, I would say, maybe? No, it's pretty even. Spawning in the top right-hand position, we have SMGJ Tech. He's the green Protoss. On the top left, we do have our blue Terran player. His name is Wolfbarla. He's on Team Groupon. There we go. It's pretty even for both. I would say two base timings are pretty good here with Protoss. Unless you do some type of cool cheese. You can put a proxy starport right here and just have an oracle the crap out of this. It's so hilarious. Oh, my boy Cat Whale does that. He's tight. Nine pylon scout. He's one down. This is game point for Wolf Brother. He needs... SMGJ Tech needs to win this in order to win, stay in this series. Stay in these matches. I can imagine... the stress that these guys had at Ignite Gaming. I mean, probably smelled treats from the snack bar. Probably heard people raging over LOL. And they're like, I just want to focus on my game. We're going to see that Reaper again from what it looks like. We're going to see some harassment on this SCV. It's very close to the other SCVs. It's not going to be a big deal. So, but he can pull those back. Doesn't need to deal with it just right now. We're seeing a gateway opening. We sure are. Single gas. So I'm not necessarily sure what he's going to be doing, but SMGJ Tech is definitely doing more macro builds, wanting to get a third, wanting to macro up an army. Death Ball. But Wolf Brother being on top of that made army to destroy parts of Death Ball, so Death Ball did not become so Death Ball-y. A second probe. Coming up to the gold expand. Is he scouting? No, he's putting a probe down, so we're gonna see. Where's that second gas, though? We might be seeing a four gate. We might. We might. I mean, this Reaper is not going to go here. It's gonna go straight to this base. But it's gonna, I mean, when you get, oh, you should wonder where the second pylon is. If the second pylon isn't there, or the third pylon isn't really there by, like, around 4 minutes? Like, where are the pylons at? You only have one pylon in your base, dude, and he's gonna lose this SCV. No, he's not. Oh, clutch. So, yeah, this isn't, I wouldn't see, like, because I didn't see the other gas, I wouldn't worry about it as much, but then I'd be like, okay, so he's gonna do, like, a one base all in or something. We are seeing the expand go on the low ground, and this may be this is really good meta actually, because I mean SMGJ Tech knows that Wolf Brother's got a Reaper expand, so and there's three probes here? Or those two probes? Yeah, there's one up there, but okay. Can you kill that? Yeah, good, and kill this one too. Yep, proxy Stargate. It's gonna be an Oracle most likely. So I mean, this is using pretty good meta because. You know that Wolf Brother is going to expand. Like, you know he expands on the low ground. He makes a Reaper. He's going to scout you. But you can take advantage of that. You can take advantage of the fact that he's not going to have too many Marines out very quickly. Because he doesn't have any Marines out right now. He's working on his first two. And you need a good number of Marines in order to stop any sort of Oracle. Unless, of course, if you really sniff it out. Oh, are we seeing a quick third CC? No, we're not. That would have been super, super sick. But that would have been death. So that Oracle's being chronoed out, and it's going to be absolutely terrible. But awesome. Because it works, you know? Do have Reaper looking around for... Wolf Brother knows something, so his Reaper's going around. He's looking for some type of proxy, but this is where it is. It's always up here. The proxy Stargate's always up here on Habitation. It's terrible. And there comes that first Oracle. We're going to see if it does its job. See how well it does. We do have four Marines, which is not enough, but we do have more coming out right here. One, two, three, or no. I'm going to take out these Marines. Not going to care one bit. Oh, that's terrible. Such a loss of... Well, you got the other ones now. He's going to... Yeah, he's got to be careful. He can't overextend. So this Oracle doesn't have much life left, but it got... didn't do that good. He only got four. It should have got like 10. When it gets 10, that's when it's really, really... Here comes the second one! Oh my god! Here's the second one. And we have another one in production. So when we have three, that's tough to stop. So he needs to put down an NG bay. Yeah, he put down his NG bay immediately. And is like, I need a turret, because this shit's not cool. We do have more gateways behind this, so this may be a one base timing. I mean, do we have warpins? Here comes... Well, the third one's not going to be in there, but... Oh, gosh. Oh, it's... But he's pulling the army away. These two could go right in. Yes, he's going to go right in, and you better snipe this if you want to live. Yes, sniping it and getting out of there. And where's the other one? Is the other one coming in now? Yep. Yeah, get that. You can get that right there. Oh, this is terrible. This is a nightmare. Absolutely hate this. So this is great. SMG JTech employing great micro of his three oracles. Get to kill that Reaper. That Reaper should be over here, though. Somewhere over here. Especially here. To stop this, that Reaper would have been like, oh, guess what? I just stopped you. A lot of Marines. Is he behind? SMG JTech's more behind, isn't he? He's pulling a lot of money, not putting into units just yet. We do have Wolf Brother in the worker lead, and nearly in the army lead as well. So, fifth Oracle! Oh my god. So, this is pretty awesome. I do like this. Because it's like when a Terran goes Mass Reaper against me to start. I hate it. It's terrible. But just take all this stuff out. You can do it. No, you can get out of it. You can get it. But... Got a lot of Oracles here not doing anything, though. So... But it's keeping Terran in his base. That's, like, the most important part of it. Wolf Brother about to get Supply Block. Now he's finishing his... as I speak, Wolf Brother is on top of his macro, I'll tell you that. So we do have a bit of pressure. A bunch of Stalkers and Oracles coming up. So this may be... This... Oh! Revelation... Gonna see everything in the base, know where the army is. That's pretty awesome. More Stalkers coming in. I kind of don't like Stalkers against Marines, but these Marines don't. They do have stim. They do not have combat shields. Their plus one is going right now. So we'll have to see what he could get. That you could get that, man. What are you gonna do? You're gonna kill that. And Marines moving toward not repairing that turret, and gonna lose a lot of workers here. A lot of workers are gonna die here. He probably will just need to doom drop in a second. It's double aggression, so he's gonna lose a lot of these SCVs. He's gonna lose this natural. He's gonna need to all in right after this. One brother will need to do. Yeah, he just needs to go. He needs to take everything and just all in right now. I mean, there's no reason why he shouldn't. You need to all in right now, Wolf Brother. That's all you can do. You need to all in. Use what money you have left to make shit and go kill him, because he just did. He made four oracles. He can't have that much shit if he has four oracles. How's your army supply? It's even. But oracles aren't good when there's a lot of DPS. If they die quickly, it don't matter. We are seeing double forge come down. SMG JTech is feeling comfortable, and I don't necessarily understand why at this moment, because he is going against Stim Marines with Stalkers. Is he going to warp in more stuff? He should cancel those forges, because, I mean, right now, Wolf Brother is very all-in with this. If he loses this army, he will not... this is not a good idea. Do not go up that ramp. Do not go up that ramp. Oh my god, do not go up that ramp. And... Yeah, okay, so you're still alive, but you just need to get out of there. He can see you! You can see you! He can see you! I wonder how much longer that's gonna go. Anyway, we have an SCV's made now. He's just... He's just gonna do what he can with what he's got, I think. More oracles to Ian, I think, if they go into his main. But we're having an attack here. Doesn't have enough stuff right now. Sentries are so good. And he needs to get, what's that thing called? Marauders. They're so good. And these, don't die, Marines. Be bad. So, the thing's kind of stabilized. Worker Elite is such an SMG J-Tech's, in GJ-Tech's bow. He's playing such a great game right now. That guy has, effectively destroyed the Terran. Pick him apart piece by piece. Overextending here, Wolf Brother is. I don't think he's going to be able to get the DPS he wants without his other Marines as well. And he needs to get out of there. And watch out for those medevacs. But he's keeping him in his base, not letting him do the death blow. What else is happening in here? Just a lot of gateways, man. Tons of gateways coming in. And plus one. And Wolf Brother, not liking what was going on, knew he was gone, and ended it. So it's 1-1 right now. So we'll see after win who wins this game, number 3, between SMG J-Tech and the Wolf Brother. And this is Polar Knight. Wolf Brother's been playing on Polar Knight for quite a minute now in competitive matches. He's very comfortable with his Tank Marine on this map, I feel, but I don't know if he's necessarily going to want to go tanks against a Protoss. I think it's okay, but maybe not. You need to have a really mobile force to get around AoE. So here we are. It's 1-1. What will these players do? What will SMG J-Tech do? What will Wolf Brother do? I don't know. I'm kind of excited to see it. Oh, SMG J-Tech, such a good guy! He loves hanging out. He loves his buddies. He loves playing games. That's very cool. I don't doubt we're going to see the exact same build from Wolf Brother. I think we're going to see the exact same build from SMG J-Tech. That's my prediction. My professional prediction. 9 pylon scout. Oof. So OP. Gonna know so quick. This map... it's more even or more Protoss favored, I would say, with these chokes. The 9 pylon scout will come in. We'll see the barracks go down. And we'll see that gas timing right now. We'll see 2 probes, 2 SCVs being pulled. Nope, 2 being pulled. 2 attack. 1 that'll stay on him and 1 that will be pulled back. Or both will be pulled back because no one gives, he doesn't care. How much? There's enough life left to really. Yeah, that's fine. It's gonna poke at it. Gonna poke at it. But then that other one's gonna get in the way. So we're seeing a gateway first from SMG J-Tech and his first gas fairy, his standard opening. He'll get his cyber core, be real safe, take a nexus, and then figure out what he wants to do with gateway units and whatever AoE he's willing to build. On this particular map, Protoss can proxy Tempest right here, and it's impossible to stop if you're not a good Terran. If you're not a really good Terran. So I'm not saying that Wolf Brother isn't a really good Terran. I'm just saying that it would be really hard to stop. So players, take advantage of putting a starport here and making proxy Tempest because there's no way to stop it. We are seeing the safest builds from both players. Most safe. We are having a proxy pylon go down right behind the natural. That's pretty interesting. So will we see a 4-gate? I mean, it feels right. It feels right, SMG J-Tech, do a 4-gate. I won't even be mad. I'll be happy if he does a 4-gate. I remember when all Protoss could do was 4-gate because they couldn't scout. And if they tried to do anything, they would just die. Anything else, they would just die. So they would have to defensively 4-gate. Or at least that was how things were in my league. Core coming down, we're going to see the go down the low ground, that SCV is just seeing warp gate being chrono boosted. This is actually the first time I've seen him chrono boost warp gate this whole game, so he can kind of get maybe bank on that, but does he know about this? Does Wolf Brother know about that? Yeah, Wolf Brother sees it in general, so here he goes, he's out. Wolf Brother's out. I mean, yeah, Wolf Brother's out. He saw what he needs to see. And yep, we are going to see that 4-gate. 2 more gates up. And, he needs to get stuff out Prono. Wolf Brother needs to make Marines Prono. Is he supply blocked too? Oh, that's terrible. Well, nearly. It's happening right now. It'll open up, and he'll be able to get out some Marines to be able to stop this. Stop or something. I don't necessarily know if he's going to have enough to stop it. We do have a lot of probes that were made. We have 22. So, I mean, warp gate will be done by, what, six minutes? 6.5 minutes? And that's when it will begin. We have a stalker all the way up to cause some hurt on this here Reaper. We do have two... I don't know if it's going to be enough. Oh, he does kill a Reaper, unfortunately. We'll push that stalker off a bit. He needs to be careful. Uh-oh. Will he get these Marine kills? That would be terrible. Yes, he probably will. And we are having another pylon go up in the front. And two stalkers against not that many Marines is pretty... Oh, no, he's going to get it. So, Wolf Brother is microing quite well. He's being able to take care of the stalker aggression. Oh, but the first warping is here. And he canceled that orbital command. He's getting out of there. He needs to get up in his base right now. Oh my god. The telltale sign that the foregate is coming, I mean, just that pylon and then seeing warpgate being researched, I think maybe canceling the expand would have been a good idea. And just getting on top of marine production. Or canceling it and putting it up here or something. I don't know. So this is going to be really hard. This bunker is not going to be done. SMG JTech employing the foregate in a very, very strong way. This is very hard to stop, especially when the meta has been, hey, expand. So SMG JTech is on top of knowing what to do against his players. He's going to do something different, like, every time. And GG. And SMG JTech takes this best of three. I want to thank Ignite Gaming Lounge, Megan Silvari, Void Ray, Wolf Brother, Method Mizzen, SMG JTech, Slowmo. Whoever else is in the League of StarCraft Chicago, I'm so excited to be casting these games and been doing funds all spring season. And this is from week 2.